Christmas Day, I'm wrapping presents, taking out trash on garbage day. Valentine's, I'm writing cards and think about giving my heart away. Halloween, costumes, I'm dressing as a tardigrade. A tardigrade? Yeah, I'm really just all about Darwin Day. That should be a statutory holiday, if you ask me, globally, not nationally. A day off work to actually read comparative anatomy, biogeography, genetics, and paleontology, and some Teddy Dobzhansky. Nothing in life makes sense except in the light of evolution. So February 12th is the birthday of the first human with the solution to the mystery of existence. Why the hummingbird? Why the orchid? Why the rhinoceros? Why the pine tree? Why the wasp? And why the porpoise? Why the mass extinction of the vast majority of life forms that ever lived? What did the dinosaurs have to die for? Why, God? Why did you have to take the triceratops and leave the mosquito intact? Is that a theological paradox? No, it's not. Darwin gave us the master plan. Actually, the lack of a master plan, the tragic dance of natural selection, the struggle for existence where organisms compete but they don't recover from extinction, the tree of life connected by lines of common descent, amoebas, plants, fish, frogs, snakes, rats, hominids, and humans, diversified and adapted to habitats as widely varied as glaciers and savannas. As molecular evidence is collected, individual gaps vanish. Humans are now known to have common ancestors with bananas and cabbages, and subject to the law of averages, not every human is aware of evolution's explanatory advantages. Some of us prefer particular religious scriptures instead of scientific experts to explain how all of this works. There are many versions, from the ancient Egyptians to the Bible and Quran and the Hindu Rig Veda's inscriptions, and this presents a challenge to teachers of biology, whose students believe in some of these creation stories, probably. In some countries, they have established state religions which dictate curriculums, like in Saudi Arabia, for instance. But in other countries, the establishment of any one religion by the government is constitutionally prohibited. For instance, the American justice system has shown a solid preference for science education based on theories with solid evidence, and there's no alternative scientific theory to Darwin's because all the others hit miraculous explanatory problems like, how does a creator create a dragonfly? Is it a mystery? You need a causal explanation to explain it scientifically, and Darwin gave us the only causal explanation in history that accounts for the origins of all biological complexity without miracles. We can study and map it and track it back to the level of deoxyribonucleic acid, but what we can't do is teach religion and call it science, because choosing among religions can be a major cause of violence. So as a practical matter, religions get equal treatment with each other, not with science. You have the right to believe it, but you don't have the right to preach it to young people with taxpayer funding, unless you teach it in comparative religion classes or something. So this is my salute to the science teachers who get it, who refuse to let a student pass a test with God did it. And this is my salute to the National Association of Biology Teachers for the consistent stand that they've taken again and again in defense of evolution against attacks from creationists who tell Bible stories in science class. And this is my salute to Charles Darwin on his birthday for his major contributions to the human mental workspace. What Darwin discovered is deeper than anyone's personal preference. I look forward to the day of its universal acceptance. Happy Darwin Day.